Now we are going to see the limiting reagents. It's very important concept. All the chemical reaction need not to be take place in terms of stoichiometric. Sometimes it not be follow the stoichiometric quantities. Now we move to the limiting reagent. If the reaction is carried out with the stoichiometric quantities of reactants, then all the reactants will be converted into product. That is stoichiometric equation. This is the way the chemical reaction carry over in the terms of stoichiometric. What is it? If it is stoichiometric, whatever the reactant involved in the reaction, all it converted to the product 100%. It is stoichiometric equation. When a reaction is carried out using non-stoichiometric quantities of the reactants, then the product yield will be determined by the reactants. That is completely consumed. So in the reactant that is completely consumed, it limits the further reaction from taking place. And it is called as the limiting reagent. The other reagent which are in excess are called the excess reagent. Then for understanding better, we move to the preparation of kesari again. 2 cups of sugar are needed for every cup of rava. What is the meaning? 1 cup rava and 2 cups of sugar we need. Consider a situation where 8 cups of sugar and 3 cups of rava are available. 8 cups of sugar and 3 cups of rava. For 3 cups of rava, we need only 6 cups of sugar alone. But we have 8 cups of sugar. Now, can you say which is the limiting reagent? Yes, obviously rava. Until the 3 cups of rava alone, we can prepare the kesari. Even though we have more sugars, but we can't prepare. So here rava, 3 cups of rava is the limiting reagent. The same way we move to the chemical reaction, we consider one chemical reaction. S plus 3F2, it gives us SF6. Here 3 moles of sulfur are allowed to react with 12 moles of fluorine to give sulfur hexafluoride. What is that? 3 moles of sulfur are allowed to react with 12 moles of fluorine to give sulfur hexafluoride. As per the equation, we know 1 mole of sulfur react with 3 moles of fluorine to form 1 mole of sulfur hexafluoride. And therefore, 3 moles of sulfur react with 9 moles of fluorine to form 3 moles of sulfur hexafluoride. Can you guess what may be the limiting reagent? Yes, sulfur is the limiting reagent. Why? Until the sulfur available alone, the chemical reaction may take place. Even though we have extra 3 moles of fluorine, there is no chemical reaction take place. So sulfur is the limiting reagent and fluorine is the excess reagent. The remaining 3 moles of fluorine are in excess and they do not. Now we are going to calculate the limiting reagent. For that purpose, we are taking the preparation of urea as example. Urea, that is nothing but a commonly used nitrogen based fertilizer, is prepared by the reaction between ammonia and carbon dioxide. The chemical reaction is given below. 2NH3 plus CO2, it gives us NH2 C double bond O NH2 plus H2O. NH2C double bond O NH2 is urea. Now we are moving to the calculation in a process, that is a preparation of urea. 646 gram of ammonia is allowed to react with 1.144 kg of CO2 to form urea. If you notice the units of ammonia and carbon dioxide, it's differ, isn't it? In ammonia, they gave in gram, but for carbon dioxide, they gave in kg. So we have to convert the kg into gram. Okay, first we have to convert the kg into gram. First question, if the entire quantity of all the reactants is not consumed in the reaction, which is the limiting reagent? Which is the limiting reagent? Let us calculate one by one. For knowing the limiting reagent, we must calculate the number of moles involved in the chemical reaction. For that, we must need balanced chemical equation. What may be the balanced chemical equation is 2NH3 plus CO2. It gives us NH2 CONH2 plus H2O. From this equation, we have to take the stoichiometric coefficient. First, we have to calculate the stoichiometric coefficient. For NH3 2, CO2 1, urea 1 and water molecule 1. Then, number of moles of reactants allowed to react. Number of moles of reactants allowed to react, that is nothing but N. N is equal to mass by molar mass. What is the mass? The given mass in the question is 646 gram. What is the molar mass of ammonia NH3? 17. For hydrogen 3, for nitrogen 14. 14 plus 3 17. Then we calculate the N mass by molar mass. 646 divided by 17, that is equal to 38 moles. Then for carbon dioxide, they gave in kg, 1.144 kg. First we convert into gram. 1.144 kg into 1000, we are getting 1144 gram. Then for molar mass of CO2, we already know 44. We have to calculate the number of moles by dividing 1144 by 44. We are getting 26 moles. So number of moles of reactants allowed to react is, for ammonia 38 moles, for carbon dioxide 26 moles. Now we have to see the actual number of moles consumed during the reaction ratio. So what is the ratio? 2:1. How? We have to move to the reactant side. In the balanced equation, 2NH3 plus CO2. 2NH3 plus CO2. So 2NH3 means 2, CO2 means 1. So what is the ratio? 2:1. As per the ratio, the number of moles reacted during the reaction is 38 moles ammonia and 19 moles carbon dioxide. Then for product side, we can calculate number of moles of product, how it formed. From the equation, 1:1, urea and water molecule is 1:1. So what may be the molecules? For urea 19 moles, for water molecule 19 moles. So both are 1:1, so both have 19 moles. Now we see the Dalbar column. Actual number of moles consumed during the reaction for ammonia is 38 moles, for carbon dioxide is 19, isn't it? Here 7 moles of carbon dioxide is excess. How? The number of moles of reactants allowed to react is 26, but actually they involve only 19 moles. So how much excess? 7 moles. So which is 100% consumed? Ammonia is consumed. So what is the limiting reagent as per the table column? Ammonia is the limiting reagent. What is the excess reagent? Carbon dioxide, because it have 7 moles excess. Second question, calculate the quantity of urea formed and unreacted quantity of the excess reactant. Here, what is the quantity of urea formed? The number of moles of urea formed into molar mass of urea. We already know number of moles of urea formed is 19 moles and molar mass of urea is 60 gram per mole. How 60 gram? NH2CO, NH2. For N, 14. For hydrogen, 2. and for carbon 12 and for oxygen 16 and again N 14 and for hydrogen 2. So totally 60 gram per mole. That is a molar mass of urea. Both we multiply, we are getting 1140 gram. It is in gram. We have to convert into kg. By dividing by 1000, we are getting 1.14 kg. So excess reagent left over at the end of the reaction is carbon dioxide. Then amount of carbon dioxide left over. What is that? Again, the number of moles of carbon dioxide left over into molar mass of carbon dioxide. What is the number of moles? 7 moles. What is the molar mass? 44 gram per mole. How? For carbon 12, for oxygen 16. There are 2 oxygen. So 32 plus 12, 44. So both we multiply, we are getting 308 gram. So this is a way we are going to calculate the what is the limiting reagent, what is the excess reagent, what is the amount left over, whatever else we can calculate by using this method. Children, try to do by yourself the same problem. It will be useful to you to work out the book back problem.